Okay, today we're going to use Hess's law to calculate the enthalpy of a chemical reaction. So what is Hess's law? Well, remember that Hess's law is something that we use when we cannot directly calculate the change in enthalpy for a certain reaction. Hess's law says it doesn't matter how you get there, basically as long as you get there. What are the key points to remember when using Hess's law? The first is that if you flip a chemical reaction, you must change the sign on the enthalpy. So again, remember first, if you flip, you change sign. Okay. Second thing that's really important to remember, if you multiply or divide any reaction to get a certain number of moles of something, you must also multiply or divide the change in enthalpy that is tied to that particular reaction. So if you multiply or divide, you must also do the same to the change in enthalpy. Okay, so with those two things in mind, let's go ahead and get started. We're going to calculate the enthalpy of the following reaction. CS2 liquid plus 3O2 gas gives CO2 gas and 2SO2 gas. And we are given the following information. We're given three equations, each with a specific enthalpy. To make life easier, I like to number them or letter them or somehow identify them. So we have 1, 2, and 3 here. And we are going to use these three equations to get the change in enthalpy for this reaction. I think the best way to start is to start with the first compound here that we're looking for. We're looking for CS2 liquid. Okay. Of the three equations that we're given, only one has that particular compound in it. That would be equation 3. In equation 3, it is on the right-hand side of the arrow. However, the equation that we're trying to get to has it on the left. So let's flip this equation over. So we're going to have CS2 liquid. Oops, only one product there. So let's erase that arrow. Okay. Arrow, we're flipping this over. CS2 gives solid carbon and 2 solid sulfur. Again, remember when you flip an equation, you must change the sign. So now instead of positive 87.9 kilojoules per mole, it is negative 87.9 kilojoules per mole. We only needed one CS2, that's all we have, so we do not need to multiply or divide this equation by anything. Okay, let's look at the O2 next, the oxygen gas. Now, it looks like there are multiple equations that have oxygen gas in them. Both 1 and 2 have oxygen gas. So I say let's skip that for now. Then let's take a look at the carbon dioxide. Because there's only one equation that has carbon dioxide in it. That's equation 1. It has 1 mole of carbon dioxide as a product, which is exactly what we want. We want 1 mole of carbon dioxide as a product. So we don't have to do anything to this equation. We're just going to write it as is. Solid carbon plus oxygen gas gives carbon dioxide gas. We did nothing to this. We didn't multiply it, we didn't divide it, we didn't flip it. So we're going to leave delta H as negative 393.5 kilojoules per mole. Okay, what else do we need? Well, it looks like we need 2 sulfur dioxides here. So what is the only equation that has sulfur dioxide in it? It looks like that's equation number 2. However, equation number 2 has only 1 mole of sulfur dioxide as a product. We need 2. So what are we going to do? Well, we're going to multiply that entire equation by 2 to get us our 2 moles of sulfur dioxide. Okay. It does so happen that it's on the right side of the arrow, right? In equation 2, it is a product, and we want it as a product, so we don't have to flip it. All right, multiplying whole thing by 2. So we have 2 solid sulfurs plus 2 oxygen gases, giving us 2 SO2 gas. Now, because we multiplied this whole equation by 2, we must also multiply our enthalpy by 2. So we have negative 296.8 times 2 gives us negative 0.6 kilojoules per mole. Now, we have not fixed the oxygen yet, but let's add up everything that we have and see where we're at so we know how many oxygen we need. And then from there, we can figure out which one of these equations to use to get us there. So when adding these three equations up, we can cancel anything that appears exactly the same on both sides. So I'm going to switch colors here so we can see what we're doing. Okay, we have a solid carbon here and a solid carbon here. One of each. One's on the left side of the arrow, one's on the right. So we can go ahead and cancel those two things out. Okay. Our two sulfur solids we have here on the right-hand side of the arrow, we also have two solid sulfurs on the left-hand side of the arrow from the third equation down here. Those are identical. We can get rid of them. Okay, let's see here. We don't have any CS2 anywhere on the right-hand side, so we have to keep that. CS2 liquid. So we're going to keep this. I'm going to change colors again so we can see what we're keeping here. So we're keeping this. Also, on the left-hand side of the arrow is oxygen gas. There is one here and two here. There are none on the right-hand side. So we have to keep this and this. They're on the same side of the arrow, so we cannot cancel them out. So 1 plus 2 is 3. We have 3 O2 gas. Okay. On the right-hand side of the arrow, we have some carbon dioxide gas. Make some carbon dioxide gas. There is none on the left-hand side of the arrow, so we have to keep it. Also, the SO2 gas, the sulfur dioxide, there is none on the left side of the arrow, so we have to keep that. So we have to keep both of those. Okay, so arrow, carbon dioxide gas, plus 2 SO2 gas. Does this look like what we were looking for? Well, if we go back and look at our original equation, we wanted CS2 liquid, 1 mole, plus 3 moles of O2 gas. Okay, got that. On the right-hand side of the arrow, we wanted carbon dioxide gas. Yep, got it. And 2 sulfur dioxide gas. Got it. So we got what we wanted. We do not have to do anything with the oxygen gas. Now, to determine the enthalpy change for this reaction, we must also add up the three enthalpies. So we had negative 87.9 plus negative 393.5 plus negative 593.6 gives us a total of negative 1075 kilojoules per mole. So this is an example of using Hess's law to determine the enthalpy change for a reaction. Thank you for listening.